Hello everyone and welcome to the final presentation video for my GSOC 2020 project Cape Compatibility Layer for BeagleBone Black and BeagleBone AI. My mentors for this project were Jason Reitner, Drew Fustini, Dunya Yao and Kumar Abhishek. The whole idea behind this project was to exploit pin header compatibility between BeagleBone Black and BeagleBone AI to create a compatibility layer for the buses. Now let's look at the current state of all the project goals we discussed in the introduction video of this project. I have created header pin references for BeagleBone AI that matches with BeagleBone Black. Same symbolings has been assigned for buses like I2C, SPI, UART, etc. I was able to refactor code in Beagle tester repository, but no new examples has been added, so this goal is partially achieved. Same user space examples now work with both BeagleBone Black and BeagleBone AI whenever possible. The GPIO pin control has been tested using libgpiod on both the boards. I have created compatibility device tree overlays for the bone buses and the capes. Thanks to Robert C. Nelson, with the new U-Boot Cape Manager patch, BeagleBone AI is now able to load device tree overlays for capes during boot, just like we have for BeagleBone Black. It is now even simpler than before. A compatibility layer has been created for the bone buses and tested on BeagleBone Black Wireless and BeagleBone AI. For more information, you can check out the Cape interface pack on eWiki for details like pin header references and complementary device tree overlays for all the bone buses shown here. Hopefully, by the time you are watching this video, you will be able to use compatibility layer out of the box or by simply flashing a new BeagleBoard.org firmware image on your system. Let's see how you can manually install it on your system. You can do it in 3 steps. First, you have to update and upgrade your system. Second, update the kernel. And third, update the bootloader. For demos and tutorials on using bone buses and writing compatible overlays using compatibility layers, you can check out the official website of this project by going to deepaklorkhatri.me/gsoc2020_beagleboard.org. You will find all the resources to help you get started with writing compatible overlays for BeagleBone Black and BeagleBone AI. You can also check out blog section for short tutorials and bone buses section for compatibility layer details for each bone bus. Following are the outcomes of the compatibility layer project. Same user space code now work with both BeagleBone Black and BeagleBone AI using the same references to the drivers for peripherals assigned to the same header pins. The same device tree overlay now work for both BeagleBone Black and BeagleBone AI whenever possible. The U-Boot Cape Manager is now able to load the device tree overlays automatically during boot on BeagleBone AI just like we have for BeagleBone Black. Finally, you can now create compatible device tree overlays that work on both BeagleBone Black and BeagleBone AI. That's all for now. Thank you very much for attending this presentation. I would like to thank my mentors, all the helpful members of Beagle IRC channel, especially ZMAT, and Robert C. Nelson for helping me out throughout the project. Links for everything we talked about can be found in the description box of this video. If you have any queries, you can leave them in the comment section below. Peace.